Hi, everyone. So here's the long overdue update about Canadian Screen Week, which was February 23rd to March 1st. This is a week in which the Canadian Academy of Cinema and Television celebrate all the storytellers of Canada who tell stories using screens, whether it's film screens, television screens, or digital screens, like Out With Nat. Of course, the day after Canadian Screen Week was the day that the Independent Production Fund trailer and application was due, so it's kind of bad timing. This meant that we had to finish our application and film the trailer for But How Do You Have Sex in a matter of days.
So look who I'm with. Look, there's Kate, there's Laura, and you, I don't know if you guys know Russell yet. There's Nadine, who I've been co-writing with. So we were filming something today on the subway. It was pretty crazy. It went well though, right?
Yeah.
Just for the loss of Russell, that was crazy.
Filming went really well, it was super fast, it was super fun, and then the next day was Monday, and that was the beginning of Canadian Screen Week. So a whole bunch of us, we all got dressed up, we went to the nominees reception party, we had a great time, got some photos on the red carpet. It's always a blast to hang out with these guys. Jonathan, Laura, Kate, Adrian, Daryl, we were all partying, having a great time together, wishing the whole gang was with us. We really are great friends. The next day, I was off to Vancouver. That's because on Wednesday I was speaking at the Bell Media Diverse Screenwriting program, and that is where I spoke about the Rise of the Web series. It was a fascinating experience. I got to talk to some really great people who are really engaged, and they're really excited about writing their own web series now. So I'm really glad I had that opportunity, and I want to thank the Writers Guild of Canada for the great honor of being selected to go all the way out to Vancouver and talk to these guys during their fantastic lunch session. As great as Vancouver is and as beautiful it is, I don't think I took a single picture. Well, except for this one in an airplane, and then this one on the flight home. I spent most of my time in the hotel room editing, but I really didn't do much in Vancouver. I did make it to Gastown. I took some video of the steam-powered clock there, like every tourist does. But I spent most of my time editing. I love editing, so it's not all that bad. And of course, I found this hilarious little bit.
What does that line start with? I don't ever have that line right.
Something about being shitty.
Yeah.
We're gonna do that in this thing.
All of what I just did?
Yeah, all that.
Okay.
As some of you may know, Caitlynne no longer lives in Toronto, she lives out west. And so by sheer coincidence, as she was coming down to Toronto for the Canadian Screen Awards, she was flying into Toronto at the same time I was flying into Toronto. So we met at the airport.
Where is she?
We did it!
How are you doing?
I'm so good, how are you?
I'm awesome.
I'm just eating.
All right, now I'm cutting.
From there, we traveled directly to the Academy social night where we got to party with a bunch of celebrities, lots of new friends, fellow nominees. It was super fun. That girl can party. Friday and Saturday were spent all day fine-tuning the edit of the trailer and working on the application. Sunday was the big day of the Canadian Screen Awards. It was an incredible event. Caitlynne and Jonathan joined me on the red carpet. It was really cool. Look at how Caitlynne works the carpet. Jonathan actually knew someone in the press. At the end of the red carpet, we e-autographed this photo that got tweeted by the Academy. We snapped one of my favorite selfies of the night. Rest of the cast, of course, they would have loved to have been with us, but unfortunately it was a very expensive event. After the red carpet, my stunning wife joined us. Look at how amazing she looks in this red dress. When the ceremony began, we were at our most nervous. Look at how terrified we were. I remember my palms were all sweaty and we were, it was tense. But, you know, at the same time, it was amazing. It was a celebration of Canadian storytellers on the silver screen, the television screen, or the screen that's in your pocket. I was really, really impressed by the whole show. It was hosted by Andrea Martin. One of the greatest highlights, though, was when they got to our category, which previously was known as the Digital Original Media Fiction. I mean, it's such a mouthful. And when they got to it, they just simply said, Best Web Series. I am so glad they did that. I think this is the first Academy in the world to just simply go out there and say, Best Web Series. And they celebrated us right there with the film and television stars of Canada. We didn't win, but you know, we well, I was going to say lost. We didn't We didn't lose either. I mean, we were nominated, which is an incredible win. The winner of the award was Space Riders Division Earth. And among the those that went to the stage to accept the award was Jonas Diamond, who's the one of the producers of the show. He is one of the nicest guys I've gotten to meet in this industry. His acceptance speech was amazing. It was very inclusive of the entire community, and he too was very proud that this Academy is recognizing this kind of art form. I got to say this in person, but I'm going to say it again here. Congratulations to the whole team that made Space Riders Division Earth. The reception that followed was awesome. Hobnobbing with stars. My wife and I got to have an amazing chat with Megan Follows, who many Canadians will remember her as playing Anne of Green Gables. We got to have a great conversation about web series production and everything. Jonathan got to have a nice chit chat with Tatiana Maslany. Here's a great photo that he took with her. The food was delicious. It was so much fun. And then afterwards, there was the after party. That's when we got to be joined by Danielle and Kate and Laura, who joined us for some more red carpet photos. And here's a picture that that Kate took of the whole gang. It was overall an amazing night. Of course, the next day was Monday, and that was the deadline of the application. You'd think I'd rest, but nope. More work, more fine-tuning. We uploaded the trailer, got everything in on time. I think there was about 4 minutes to spare. Here's my chance to be able to say thank you to Laura Javely for all your crazy hard work on getting the application together. Nadine and I would not have been able to do it without you. The rest of the week was pretty chill. I got to spend time with my family, reconnect, relax, and recover. This week, I'm going to get back into some writing. I want to start writing the project, the future project. I want to get more writing done on season 4. And, and I'm working with Kate Conway on her new project called Hashtag Kate Conway is a Jerk. If you haven't watched that yet, here's a link so you can go watch that, the first episode of her web series. We're going to try and film another 2 episodes soon. So thanks for listening, everyone. I hope you don't mind it was too long, but I think it was kind of cool. Yeah, it was a crazy week. It was a crazy week, and it was pretty awesome that I get to make a web series that enables me to do all those wonderful things. And of course, I have the audience to thank for that. Thanks, guys.